Thank you and good morning. I'm John Ross, and on behalf of St. John's and the staff and the singers, and our choir is finally back together for the first time. Isn't that exciting? And just a lot of congregations. We're glad you're here this morning, and Tom said it correctly that we really are here to slow down and give thanks. Maybe take a small glance inside ourselves, maybe a short glance around our country, and really be thankful. Pause for 1 second. Do your own work about this. Where in the world do you see public religious worship done so well, I would say, but freely, peacefully, respectfully in a public park? I challenge you that does not happen very many places. You know, many papers across our country this morning in print, always print on this day, the Declaration of Independence. I take the New York Times, so this morning they had it in their paper. Many papers do. I don't need to remind you the words. Many of you know them by heart, I'm sure, better than I. But I will remind you of them. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Often so glibly tossed off, but on a day like this, they are not, are they? 256 years. 256 years. Again, we gather to, as best we can, make these words into a reality. To attempt to make these words become true for you, for our community, for the nation. And then, as a, hopefully, some guiding light for the world. You know, we are not the most multicultural nation in the world. We are not. But I want you to absorb this. We are the most multiracial democracy in the world. Absorb that, because it is true. Our diversity is ever expanding and will not decrease in that expansion. It has and will continue. And our challenge this morning, 256 years into this experiment of independence, is the same as on that first day, is it not? It is to make these words that we have just heard come true, to be livable, to be lived, to offer freedom and a deep sense of abiding peace and freedom to all of us. Life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness. I own with you, and I mean this, I am a simple parish priest. I do not know more than you. I'm more insightful. I'm not smarter. That's definitely true. I dress up in red, white, and blue this day, but be clear, I'm not being silly. I'm being playful. Like Anna Atashina over there. Y'all got to see her before the day is over. But, you know, I really do think that this day is so dramatically important. It is deeply important to me. And I'm going to say something you may or may not agree with. I do not believe our democracy is at stake. I do not. As I look around our community, and I mean locally, stay local with me for a minute. I see people every day, in and out, every day, trying to extend and provide freedom that we cherish. I watch police officers. I watch judges. I watch teachers. I watch politicians do their work to try to ensure that we are living peaceably and by the law. They are doing right things all around us. And I see an ever-growing awareness and effort to fill the disadvantage that so many have, especially our children and youth. Some of you know that I was privileged to chair the Trinity Board, and they give away a tremendous amount of money. I'm on the Petway Board. We give away a lot of money. Miss Jane was a parishioner here. She left her corpus of money to be done for good work. I watch local people, groups, agencies, churches, giving money, time, sweat, energy, conversation, toil, every day to try to bring those up who deserve a hand up, and everybody deserves a hand up. What do you see? What are we seeing? Why aren't we saying what we are seeing? It is happening. It's always happening. It doesn't mean that there aren't difficulties. That's just life, isn't it? But I don't think our democracy is at stake. But I do think, and I bet you do, that at times of challenge and disagreement and an amazing amount of anxiety, that our patriotism is a bit dampened. So I did a little survey these last few days about patriotism. And I called some people, and every one of those people is here this morning, and I asked them this question. What is patriotism? And if you hear me say anything, don't quit listening. I want you to take that question home with you. I want you to ask it around your dinner table. I want you to ask it around the grill today. I want you to ask it on the boat. What is patriotism? This is not a party day. This is a patriotic day. So hear what those people said. What is your answer as they gave theirs? A woman who's been in leadership and civic work and church work and community work her entire life, I think, she's a lifelong civilian, said this. It was after a long silence, by the way, each person had to think once to answer this question. She said, patriotism is the desire to be able to give one's life, if it was needed, for the preservation and sustaining of our democracy. I was rather touched because it wasn't Glenn. She meant it. A deep and abiding response. She kind of set the bar high, didn't she? I asked one of our nonagenarians, you know what that means, you're in your 90s. My wife had to look it up and she had to spell it for me. I'm a bad speller. And he is a true father of our community, in spirit and in action, and has been for decades. He said it succinctly. Patriotism is loyalty to and respect for the government that has enabled our country to be what it is. And then I turned to decorated combat veteran. The answer was terse to the point. Didn't say patriotism. He said, I thought so all people, regardless whether I agree or disagree with their views, can live freely and have their opinions and protest and march and do whatever they need to do to live in this land. I was humbled, to be quite honest. You know, in our country in the 1960s, late 60s, or 67, James Baldwin, not talking about patriotism, but talking about the present and our future, the future that we are now living, and the future we are looking to, said this. James Baldwin said, our task is to create ourselves without creating an enemy. Today, let's take that in. Somebody begins to need to say this. And I'm a simple parish priest. Your voices can speak. So what is patriotism for you? Maybe we make an effort today to restore it, invigorate, to express that patriotism, our love and respect for what we have been given. We didn't make it. We inherited it. We have so much. We share so much. We live so much. And we can hope so much if we will, because we live in freedom. We have the freedom to do that. A freedom unparalleled in history. It is remarkable. The story we tell is incredibly important. So I'll leave you with this. You know I love books, so I have your read for the week. Maybe some of you have already started. I started well into it, and I've read a lot from this man before. It is Admiral William McCraven. You know him. He is the commander of Special Forces. He was a Navy SEAL, is a Navy SEAL, incredibly decorated. He was at the helm during Saddam Hussein, Osama bin Laden, the rescue of Captain Phillips, and numerous other things that you can't even talk about. And you may have seen him on YouTube doing a speech to the graduating class at the University of Texas, his alma mater, a few years ago. But his book is called The Hero Code. And it is quite a read. It's fun. It's common. It's kind of history for the day. But it's amazing what he says to that class, by the way. He says a simple thing. He says, do you know that each of you, and I want you to hear it because he's speaking to us, each of us will meet 10,000 people in our life. What if we influenced or changed 10 people? Each of us. And he was talking at graduating class, and he said, if each of you changed 10, and those people changed 10, in 5 generations, 800 million lives have been touched. You see, what he was saying to those young people, what we can hear today is what we do makes the difference. And this final, and if you haven't seen it on YouTube, go watch. It is fabulous. So he says, do you know if you want to make a difference and change the world? He said, I'm going to give you some pointers, and he gave about 8 or 10, but his first was the most stunning. He said, as a Navy SEAL, we're out to change the world and fight and do the things. The first lesson you learn is to make your bed. Every day, hard seats, perfect pillow, covers in place, bounce a coin off of it, make your bed. And he said, we all scratch our heads, why would you make a bed? What does that have to do with anything? He said, well, one, you come back to it, so it's nice if you've had a bad day. But he said he finally learned the lesson that every small thing matters in some way. And that if we do little things, we begin to do bigger things. The bigger things take us to great things. You're not going to join the Navy SEALs today unless you've lost your mind. I definitely would not made it, and that's not the point. But I'll just tell you, when the sun came up this morning, and I get up super early on Sundays, I went out and I made sure that my American flag was on my porch, and my flag was at my mailbox, and yes, if you see me in town today, I have a flag on my car. I thought maybe I ought to do something small for me. You see, I put those flags out because I was trying to put the flag back in my heart, because that's where it lives. Maybe we can all put the flag and a bit of patriotism back in our hearts. It is not the only time our country has been faced with the things we are talking about. But we can use a little flag and a whole lot of patriotism. Put it back in your heart. Put it back in your lives. Because today, very shortly, begins year 257. And God bless our country.